Yo, what's good, guys? Another video here. Today we got Rob Beckett's most brutal comebacks, Jimmy Carr versus Rob Beckett. 8 out of 10 cats does countdown. Let's get it. I'm not sure if I've reacted to, I mean, he's been on the channel and like other things, like other compilations, but I'm not sure if I've reacted to anything about Rob Beckett before. I don't think he's ever been the focus, so this should be funny. Let's get to it.
Grew up in Lewisham, where because of his teeth he was technically classed as a dangerous dog.
Oh! I've seen that one before. I've seen this before.
At least I didn't have to buy him.
Oh!
What? How's that gonna do? They just call me a dog! Now, Rob, you present I'm a Celebrity, get me out of here now, don't you? Now, what's more difficult, do you think, a bush tucker trial or going up against Sean on countdown?
If I don't have to eat a kangaroo dick after this, I reckon that'll probably be harder. I mean, I don't think that's a proper sentence, but I think we all...
Wait. What?
After this.
Now, Rob, you present I'm a Celebrity, get me out of here now, don't you? Now, what's more difficult, do you think, a bush tucker trial or going up against Sean on countdown?
If I don't have to eat a kangaroo dick after this, I reckon that'll probably be harder.
You telling me this man ate a kangaroo dick off of a TV show? I value Ooh. Money. But, like, don't get me wrong. I really do value money. I don't know if anybody has enough money in the world to make me do that. He did what? Hell no. Hell no. Hell nah to the nah.
Sentence, but I think we all got the gist.
That was very much an IKEA sentence. I feel all the parts were there. We can put that together. That's really warm up for the conundrum, that sentence. Last time you were on the show, you managed a four-letter word.
Yeah. Mole, if my memory serves me correct.
Do you think you're going to sort of do better this evening?
Well, I hope so, Jim. I can't make any promises, but I'm going to try my best. I mean, I'm enthusiastic. I think, and if you can do the scores, I'll just do the morale.
The chances of it working the other way around are minute.
Rob, if you could ask any celebrity one question, what would it be?
Well, actually, I've always wanted to ask you a question. I've never found the right time, so maybe now's the right time. Can you cry? I don't want you to now, but do you have the ability to cry?
What is crying?
What?
I just can't imagine you ever just... Have you ever cried?
Yeah, I think when I had to pay the tax. Rob started brushing his teeth 9 years ago, and great news!
All right, sorry for the cut there. Fire siren went off. Hopefully, whoever that's going off for is okay. But, yeah. Back to the video. I just didn't want you guys to have to listen to a whole fire station siren going off.
Rob started brushing his teeth 9 years ago, and great news...
You only need the salt. You don't even need the
Rob started brushing his teeth 9 years ago, and great news, he's nearly finished. Okay, Rob, where do your strengths lie? I mean, you're not great with the letters or the numbers. Where do your strengths lie?
I'm good at cutting out.
I haven't
busy.
Heard that expression, like...
What, cut it out? Don't you cut
what's,
it out?
What's that mean?
You, not since, like, I was five.
Well, how'd you do your Christmas list about cutting out the Argos coat?
What?
Bit of cutting out, innit? I like it, it chills me out. See, I did three hours on a tree frog the other day.
Cutting out, I've never heard someone say that in my life. Somebody explain to me what that means, because that, like, here's my head. And that's where the joke is. It's gone. Like, it is not there. Like, it's... What?
Have you seen the things on a tree frog?
Yeah, must be quite a challenge, I mean.
3 hours, mate. The elbows are doing angles I've never seen before.
Like, wait. Is he talking about actually cutting something out? As in, like... I'm dumb. I seriously thought he was like, that was like an expression for something. If he's actually talking about cutting something out, then never mind. I know exactly what it means to cut something out. I'm just, I overthought shit because I'm stupid.
There we go. Rob Beckett, finally an answer to the question, what would it look like if during the war, Nazi scientists had tried to genetically engineer an Aryan horse? Ja, das Blondhoffen ist gut, ja.
So easy on our face.
Exactly. For a man that's engineered his entire face and hair. Well, can I talk about your hair?
Anytime you want, John, what would you
Because you've
like
had
to
a transplant, which I thought was a bit early doors for you. I didn't think you needed it. Is this what you're going
for? And we're back again. The fire station alarm went off again! gotta love it. But regardless, I hope those people are okay, as I said before, and let's get back to it. Because so far, this is Rob Beckett's best comeback of this entire video.
Wait, can I talk about your hair?
Anytime you want, what would you like?
Because you've had a transplant, which I thought was a bit early doors for you. I didn't think you needed it. Is this what you're going for, or are you? Is this, this midpoint?
This is a midpoint. What do you want? Have eyebrows, a small bit of forehead, maybe a two head,
yeah,
and then hair starting about there.
At the moment, you look a little bit like Woody from Toy Story.
That's not the hair. It's the frozen face. If you spend too much time with Catherine Ryan, this is what happens.
No, you got her into that.
Rob, your turn to choose the letters.
Vowel.
A.
Vowel.
U.
Consonant.
P.
Consonant.
R.
Vowel.
It's quite important not to say please and just bark them at her.
Coming from you. I get one off for the first 20 minutes. Give it a large one, because I said please and thank you. I've not finished yet, Jim. Hurry up, consonant. Sorry. A vowel, please.
Thanks, Rob.
Please, may I have a consonant?
D.
Bark consonant, please. That's enough. That's all right for everyone, is it?
Yep. Okay, and your time starts.
Thank you.
Now. Time to go over once again to Jamie Lang in Dictionary Corner. You're from Chelsea and you're incredibly posh. Rob, you're from Lewisham and you're not.
I thought you could go scum. You're posh and Rob, you're scum. I've got the teeth for a posh dude.
You have got the teeth of a posh man, yeah.
Yeah, I've got the teeth of a posh man. Yeah,
you should give those back. So we'll play a quiz to see how much you know about each other's world.
God damn! I feel like that was more brutal than Jimmy's part. God damn! Okay. Jesus!
I've got the teeth of a posh man, yeah.
Yeah, I've got the teeth of a posh man.
You should give those back. Okay, so we're going to play a quiz to see how much you know about each other's worlds. To the podiums.
I'm ready, mate.
I'm ready, mate. Is that okay?
It is like a demonstration of, yeah, you can dye your hair blonde, but don't get carried away.
Mine's not that bad, is it?
Yeah, it is, yeah.
I know that I'm going back to the future. Biff Tannen, Doc.
It looks like when twins get separated and one is raised rich and one is raised poor.
All right, Rob, you've got questions about Chelsea and posh things, and Jamie, you've got questions about Lewisham and other stuff. Here we go. Yeah, that's where the money goes.
I feel so tense now, isn't it?
Okay, Jamie, what does the acronym CHAV stand for?
Acronym.
I hope this answers it. What is a CHAV? I've never heard that word in my life. I feel like that's some kind of insult. Like, I feel like, you know, that would be used as, like, you're a fucking chav. I'm guessing.
Chav. It means chav. Someone help me out. It's not an acronym.
It's not an acronym.
It originated from people from Chatham because they used to call them chavs. So you're talking out your arse, mate.
So you're full of shit, basically. Okay.
Sorry, sir.
Okay, according to this, it's council-housed and violent. Chav.
That's, you just knit that from a Plan B song. You don't mean that. It comes from
Here's a fun fact. Before becoming a stand-up, Rob worked in a kitchen as an industrial food blender. I can't help feeling that with the glasses, you look like sort of a Nazi scientist.
How? Tell me how, in two sentences, he not only calls him a food grinder because of his teeth, he also calls him a Nazi.
I can't help feeling that with the glasses, you look like sort of a Nazi scientist.
If I do this, I look a bit like someone from like the too distant future.
Oh, yeah.
Like, hello and welcome.
Wait, no, he low-key does, though.
I will be your guide.
Like those weird robots in like the movies. He's like, hello, I am the evolved version of Alexa. Low-key, I could see that.
Oh, yeah. Like, hello and welcome.
I'm gonna be honest though, I don't feel like these are very brutal. Like, he's had a few that were kind of brutal. But, like, honestly, I wouldn't call these brutal comebacks for the most part at all. Like, Jimmy's insults have been much more brutal than his comebacks for the most part. Unless they're just flying over my head because I'm literally reacting to this half asleep. But, videos must come out.
I will be your guide.
The clue was, that'll stop him. It was, of course, thwarted. Okay, before we go on, Joe Wilkinson's on holiday, but he has sent his half-brother, Fabio, with a postcard for Rachel. Fabio?
All right. Thanks.
What the fuck?
Do you want to read the postcard?
Sure, because, dear Rachel, I can't make it because I'm still on holiday, but this week, because I ran out of money, I'm staying at my local home base. Anyway, this week I thought Sean and John could do with some help because they're both dog shit at Countdown.
What? I feel like I've seen this clips from this episode before. What the fuck? Why? Sean, what the fuck are you doing, man? Like, I feel... Oh my fucking god. Okay, it's this thing. Okay, that just has to come off. I'm sorry for that. But, like, why the hell does Sean have a fucking... Why? You know, this is supposed to be about Rob, Sean, moving on.
Sent along some extra teammates for them. Jimmy's got the details. Wish you were here. By that, I mean, I wish Susie was here. The rest of you can piss right off. Joe, PS, tell Jimmy he's a gonad.
Okay, well, as you've just heard, you're going to get new teammates. Let's meet the players.
Let's go.
Okay, it's Rob and Jono. I'll tell you a little bit about them. Jono is an 8-time Countdown champion. He's an octo champ. Woo! Rob Beckett is a stand-up comedian and the worst ever Cats Does Countdown player, which means he's the worst ever player of Countdown ever.
Damn!
He also seems to be dressed from the neck down as a lesbian.
Sure it's from the neck or just from the forehead?
His hair is quite... Yeah, you can... I'll give you some stats on these boys. Okay, the Octo Champs won 8 games. Rob has won none. Octo Champ's longest ever word was desolated. Rob's was the word pubes. Spelled with a Z.
Urban, innit? Yeah. We're moving on, Jim. It's the future now, yeah? Can't spell it like the old ways. Shakespeare didn't listen to anyone, did he, about words? He started knocking out new ones.
Yeah, you're like the new Shakespeare.
Okay. See what he used to wear? Like a right state.
Okay, now, John, you're trailing horribly today. It's 0 to you, 28 to Sean. Who are you going to pick? I think I know the answer to this.
Well, I believe in changing destinies, Jimmy. I believe in new chances. And if it's all right with Vic, I would like Rob.
Really?
I like how even Rob was shocked by that. Like, what? you know, I like Rob. Like, this is kind of the first little bit of, like, Rob I've really seen. I like him. He seems like he's a cool guy. Like, definitely seems like he's a cool guy. But I can't really say these were the most brutal comebacks. Like, he had a couple good ones. But I feel like, for the most part, I feel like, nah. Like, I don't think these were that brutal. Just being honest. But, you know, that's my personal opinion. Now, feel free to yell at me and scream at me in the comments for having an opinion, because how dare I? It's 2022. You know, because it will boost me in the algorithm. So yell at me if you made it to the end. And if you did make it to the end, do you see the people who yell at me for having an opinion? Yell at them for having an opinion about my opinion. And then we can all just argue and boost me in the comments even more, because, you know, that's what matters at the end of the day. Give me views. Bye. I should say, I'm joking, unless you want to. You know, if you want to, do it, but I am joking. Or am I? Maybe I'm not. The world may never know.